Hello all, this is Ashwin again. How are you all doing? So in this video lecture, we are going to see what multi-level inheritance is and how to implement that in Python. So let's get started with understanding the concept of multi-level inheritance. So this diagram depicts an example of multi-level inheritance. So here class A is the parent class. Class B is the child class of class A. Also the class B serves as a parent for class C. And class C is the child for class B. So here class A, class B and class C all play unique roles. In the sense, class A is the only only class which happens to be a parent class. Okay, it's a purely parent class. Class C is the child class. Okay, but here the class B plays the role of a parent as well as the role of a child class. So this sort of inheritance is known as multi-level inheritance. Many times we have to organize our classes in a way that that there are like levels of the classes which are derived from one another. So this sort of inheritance is known as multi-level inheritance. So let's see an example here in Python. So suppose there is a class person. And let's not add any sort of member method or attribute as of now. Let's say there is another class, class employee. Okay, and let's derive it from class person. Pass. Then there is a class programmer. Programmer and then let's derive it from employee. Okay, so let's not add again anything in this. Let's write the main method, def main function, sorry. And in this main function, we are going to create an object of class programmer. Okay, so programmer, just say obj1 equal to programmer. So this is how we can write the code for multi-level inheritance. Now here in this example, we can actually have a lot of stuff. We can actually add a lot of stuff to the classes. So let's first finish coding for the skeleton of the code. Main, and just say main function. Okay, so here we are calling the main function as our usual exercise. So here we can have a simple simple thing like assign. Okay, def assign. So usually it will be name comma age. Okay, and then here we can just say self. Okay, it's a method. So self dot name equal to name, and self dot age equal to age. Okay, so this is how we assign the stuff to this is how we assign the values of name and age to the person. The same way we can assign an employee ID. Assign basic, we will say. Okay, and then we can say assign def assign employee emp self and ID. Okay, and here we will just say self dot id equal to id. I think that it's a key reserve word. So IDNO, we will just say identification number. And the final method will be something like def assign prog self comma lang. Lang stands for programming language that he is comfortable with. We'll just say self.lang equal to land. Okay, so now let's see all these methods in action. So now we have created the object, object one, which the type of which is programmer, right? So anyway, programmer is a child class of class employee, and employee happens to be the child class of class person, right? So the methods assign basic as well as assign emp are can be accessed by the object of class programmer. So let's see how to do that. Obj1 dot assign basic let's say Ashwin comma 31 obj1 dot assign emp. It's let's say 1002 and obj1 dot assign prog is Python. Okay, Python 3 to be very specific about this stuff, and then we can just like print the values using print ob print of obj1 dot name comma obj1 dot obj1 dot age id number and lang. Okay, age comma obj1 dot idno comma obj1 dot lang. I think that we will have to convert age as well as id number to a string, but let's try to execute this code and let's see what problem actually it encounters. So let's run the code. Okay, it seems that programmer object doesn't have attribute id number. Okay, so let's see. Okay, I think that there is a problem with this code. So we are actually assigning the self.id number. Okay, and now let's try to execute this code. Okay, it seems that the code executed successfully. We did not have to convert the numbers to the string. So it displays my name, my age, my id number, and the specialization of the programming language that I know very well. So this is how we can use multiple inheritance. So this is a very real life example which you can find in any organization, or if you check any sort of like payroll system which has been created with Python, then that payroll system might have this sort of hierarchy of the classes, right? That there is one base class and base class or parent class, and then there is a child class, and then there is another child class which happens to be the child of the child. So this is how the multi-level inheritance works here in Python. So you can actually try multiple examples of multiple inheritances. Just say so one real life example is like animal. Okay, and then we can just say primates, then we can just say great apes, and then we can say humans. Or I guess I have got this order wrong. And humans. So this is actually one of the real life examples of the multi-level inheritances, because all these classes like animals, great apes, and primates, these are all abstract classes, and humans is the only real class. Very soon we are also going to see what abstract classes mean. And this is the very real life example of multi-level inheritance. Or we can also say vehicle, and then we can say land-based vehicles, land vehicles. We can then say land vehicles and four-wheelers, automobiles, and automobiles can be further extended by two wheels, and then motorbikes. So these are like some real life examples of multi-level inheritance. So as an exercise for this tutorial, you can just like create, try to write the code and as well as the attributes for all these real life examples. So thanks a lot for watching my videos. Please do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos on Python 3 programming. Thanks a lot.